back live at E3. Time to cool things down a little bit here. We've got SSX. So let's talk a little bit about this reboot. It's a whole new take on SSX, isn't it?
Yeah, you know, when we had the opportunity to bring back what we consider to be one of the greatest franchises in EA Sports history, we knew we wanted to do something big. We knew we wanted this to be a launching point where SSX wouldn't go dormant for another 5 years, where, you know, we could have SSX around for a while. So it's a totally new game, brand new tech. We've harvested some of the best tech from around EA. And, you know, in terms of that, it's all new. In terms of design, there's a lot of stuff that SSX fans are going to be happy with in there.
There's some really cool tech we were talking about. I was reading something this morning about a... like you could punch in coordinates and it can make a map. So how does that work?
So that's what we use in development. So in early days, and what really gave us a big springboard for, you know, developing SSX, we sourced topography data of the entire planet Earth from NASA. And we built a proprietary tool that we call Mountain Man that we use to sort of model, shape the terrain, and really create sort of those thematic environments that SSX fans expect. And we got to a point where we could type in the latitude and longitude coordinates of any mountain on Earth and press a button, and Mountain Man would create a three-dimensional model from NASA satellite data of that mountain and all the surrounding mountains in about 28 seconds. And that's amazing for us, but really that's where our work just begins, because then we use some of the most talented world builders, level designers, and artists to shape, mold, and we take a lot of creative liberties with the terrain that we find there to create that over-the-top gameplay experience you'd expect in SSX.
Yeah, because I think these mountains would probably kill a lot of people in real life.
Yes, they would.
So, I guess with the different places that you're going to be going, I didn't see Tahoe on that list, and that's where I go. So, like, theoretically, like, if with your tools, you'd be able to make North Star or, you know, Sierra Tahoe,
you know,
or something
we thought
like that.
In early days, and we had a lot of people ask us, you know, are you going to have Whistler, are you going to have Aspen, are you going to have a lot of resort mountains? But, you know, if you want to go ride those mountains, go ride those mountains. We wanted to take the player to places where very few people on Earth would ever have the opportunity to snowboard. Antarctica, you know, high elevation in the Himalayas, the Alps, Alaska, Siberia. We really wanted to take players to places they couldn't actually go.
Right, so going down Sugar and Spice, my little green route that I tend to take.
Not going
to
happen.
No, that's probably for the best. I can barely link terms. So, all right, let's talk about the three major game modes here.
Sure. So, you know, our original tagline, and from day one in development, we've been working on delivering Race It, Trick It, and Survive It. So racing and tricking, if you're an SSX fan, should be very familiar to people. Racing, you know, sense of speed. We really wanted to deliver a feeling of kind of burnout on snow with our races and riding on the edge of control and going more fast than you're even comfortable going. Trick It, again, Trick It is really the foundation upon which SSX was built.
Let's talk about the control scheme, because, you know, the PS2 days, I mean, SSX is synonymous, you know, with the PS2. And, you know, you would use the buttons, but you all, I heard, maybe were taking a page out of Skate's book and doing things with the analogs.
You know, something really cool that we're doing and that we're really proud of is we're actually doing both. So something I've always wanted to do my entire career as a designer, in SSX, we're going to have two live control schemes at all times. You don't have to flip any buttons or do anything to change between them. So if you are, you know, you like to play a lot of shooters, you played a lot of Skate, if you like using the right analog stick to, you know, do an ollie type move to preload and jump, do all kinds of spins and flips and tricks and grabs in the air, you can do that with your right analog stick. If you're more like me, old school gamer, I actually prefer using buttons. You can actually use all the buttons in the game, and we've actually got a really clever design for the buttons where you can literally do everything you can do with the stick, also with the buttons, or you can flip back and forth between the two, whatever, you know, whatever floats your boat.
Choice, yes. All right, so I was reading also in one of these articles that you were referring to these deadly descents as sort of like a boss battle. What is that?
Sure. So deadly descents in SSX take us to a place the franchise hasn't been before. And the best analogy that I can use for them is that they act like boss fights in our game. So in campaign mode, the typical flow that you'll go through is you'll arrive in a region, you'll spend most of your time doing race events and trick events, and then the summit descent from the biggest, nastiest, scariest mountain in the region will have a deadly descent, and you have to beat that deadly descent to move on to the next region, and we take you around the world in similar fashion. So deadly descents in game design terms are what I refer to as exciters and delighters. They're like the C-135 mission in Modern Warfare, crawling through the grass in the sniper mission. They're meant to be a really cool and unique one-off type of gameplay experience.
Break it up. So you're doing something different.
Yeah, different camera angles, different presentation, more of a cinematic NIS introduction to them. They're really fun, and they provide a really cool beat chart for the player.
Okay, so we actually have some questions in from the Twitterverse. So
sure.
Sid, come on in here, and what do people want to know?
Here's a great question. I was a huge fan of the first SSX, so I know exactly why David Dole is asking this question. Do the music tracks and SSX build up as you play better as in the previous games, and how important is music to the overall experience?
That's a great question, actually. So we realized, obviously, in very early days, music has always been a very huge part. If you look at some of the soundtracks SSX has shipped with in the past, huge artists that went on to do amazing, great things. So we know music is really important. Also, SSX was one of the first games that really integrated music as a form of feedback into how you're doing in gameplay. We're not releasing a lot of details about what we're doing with music just yet, but I can assure you your music, your soundtrack is going to change based on what you're doing in gameplay, and we've got some really big artists that we're hoping to sign. We've got big plans for music for sure.
Let's talk about customization a little bit here. I mean, you know, you go to a ski resort, no two people look the same.
Sure.
And so what do you get to do with your characters?
Yeah, you know, in early days, we really wanted to create a gear design that every single piece of gear that the player can equip themselves with has a fundamental effect on their gameplay. So we're always thinking gameplay first with SSX. So what we're hoping to do is deliver a very RPG light type of an inventory system with tons and tons of different gear options
do
that
you
all
level
change
up,
gameplay.
Or?
All your pieces of gear level up,
nice.
Your character levels up along with that. We've got rare items and epic items. We've got a really cool gear design coming. I think players are going to have a great... We want to do what Borderlands did for guns with gear at SSX, and we'll see how that all nets out, but we have some really ambitious plans.
So are there drops? Do you find stuff, or do you just buy things based on how well you do?
So every time you load into an SSX level, you select your character, and then you get to select from different gear options, and you get to equip your character with a different board, different kits,
right.
Different pieces of equipment, and then you can actually apply boosts to them as well. And you actually pass through that screen every single time you go into gameplay. There's opportunities, you earn money in the game, and you can use your money to buy items. It's a pretty cool design. I think players are going to love it.
Okay. Did we have any other questions from Twitter?
We've got a lot. Here's a simple one. I put you on the spot with this one. VIP Luxury wants to know, are you going to have a turbo like SSX Tricky?
Luxurious.
Yeah, we absolutely have a turbo button. Of course, that's a fundamental staple of SSX. So the way the system works is, you know, tricks are the economy of gameplay in SSX. They always have been. And whether you're doing a race event, a trick event, or even a deadly descent, a survival event, you're going to need to do tricks in order to be successful. So every time the player does tricks, they build themselves up. You can see they have a meter at the bottom of the screen, typical SSX. They build up and earn themselves some boost. They can then spend that boost with the turbo button to help them go faster, or they can hold that off, and when they fill their meter up, they go into what we call tricky, which is when we get some of the biggest, craziest, over-the-top, known as Uber tricks in SSX. All the tricks in the entire game are then replaced with an Uber version of those tricks. You kick both your feet out of the bindings and truly defy reality.
So, SSX, synonymous with the PS2 generation. Now into PS3, PS3 gamers actually get a bonus, so let's talk about Mount Fuji.
Yeah, so only exclusive on the PlayStation 3. We're going to allow players to explore and drop themselves onto one of the most iconic mountains in the world, Mount
Volcano.
Fuji, in Japan, which is a natural volcano.
Yes.
You know, we looked at Mount Fuji at first, and we kind of thought, wow, that's a great mountain. Everyone's heard of it. It would be really cool to go there. And then we actually looked at it, and we're like, wow, people can hike up that mountain in like an afternoon, and tourists take pictures of it. We're like, that doesn't feel like a very fun place for SSX kind of gameplay. But then we thought, let's just go ahead and let you go inside the volcano. And so we're going to let players drop themselves inside the volcano where they're going to find a maze of different paths and different routes to go down. We have big plans for Mount Fuji, and only PlayStation 3 owners are going to get to experience that.
Very cool. Very cool bonus for SSX. And actually, before we wrap up, it looks like even more questions coming through Twitter.
More questions. Bring
more
them on.
Questions. There's a big theme that's being developed here. It's about multiplayer. They want to know, what are the multiplayer options? Is there going to be split screen? Getting that from a lot of folks.
Sure. So in SSX, we have very big, ambitious plans for what we're doing with multiplayer and online. I think SSX always had an incredibly strong multiplayer component. You know, SSX, old school Tony Hawk back in the days, these to me were the original party games. I wasted a lot of my youth playing those games and trying to best my friends. We're not revealing details on what we're doing with multiplayer and online until Gamescom in August in Cologne, Germany. But what we have told people that they can take whatever they want from is that we took a lot of inspiration from what Criterion, you can tell I'm a big fan of Criterion's work. We took a lot of inspiration from what they did with Autolog in Need for Speed Hot Pursuit. And, you know, speaking with those guys, the biggest thing for them was we wanted to put friends at the absolute heart of your game and competing with friends and make that as easy and seamless and integrated as possible. We have some really cool stuff that we're going to reveal, but not yet.
Cool. If it's anything like Autolog, that's a great way to keep people coming back and you're trying to best your times and things like that. So sounds like you're on the right track, and we'll be eager to see what you do this summer in Gamescom.